Hello, students, faculty, and staff of the Grady County School System. We're excited to welcome the members of the Cairo Grady County community to join us in such a monumental occasion. The Cairo High School Sage Club has presented a unique opportunity to us all. Today, we will witness the first virtual Black History program. We ask that you listen and learn attentively as we educate and celebrate together.
I've been walking with my face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders. I do what I can when I can while I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, I hear freedom calling, calling me to answer. Gotta keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones. I go to prepare a place for you. I go to prepare a place for you. I go to prepare a place for you. I go to prepare a place for you.
Assistant Principal at Cairo High School. Welcome to our 2021 Cairo High School Black History Program. SAGE stands for Student Advocates for Georgia Education. The mission and purpose of this student organization is to cultivate the students' understanding of the value of education. With this in mind, it is important to acknowledge Black history as an essential component of American history. In 1976, President Gerald Ford officially recognized Black History Month by encouraging everyone to seize the opportunity to honor the too often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout history. Today, our goal is to highlight the accomplishments of Black Americans in history so that we can celebrate the impact that they have had on our everyday lives. Usually, we would all be assembled in our gymnasium to watch the program, but in these COVID times, we have had to be innovative and creative. Our students and faculty have worked very hard to provide a more interactive celebration this year. We have been able to tour our virtual Black History Museum using QR codes around the school, answer Black History trivia questions, and learn new facts each day, and even had an intense door decorating contest. This year's celebration has definitely been one to remember. We ask that you listen and learn attentively as we educate and celebrate together. On behalf of the Cairo High School Sage Club, welcome to our Black History Program. We will begin with the Pledge of Allegiance to the American flag. Please stand as our pledge is presented by Brooke Hillgartner.
Salute the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I am Sophia Lopez Morales, a freshman at Cairo High School. The Cairo High School chorus has made some great strides and very unique opportunities over the past few years. Unfortunately, in March of 2020, concerts were canceled, schools were shut down, and life as we knew it came to a screeching halt due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The CHS chorus was forced to find and develop a new normal. They had to follow different guidelines for their performances to keep everyone safe. The director of choral activities at Cairo High School, Ms. Erica Edwards, proposed showcasing the performance from February 2020 that portrays unity and a time that we were once able to gather together and sing. Next, we will have the Black National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing. Our 2019 through 2020 Cairo High School chorus performed in a collaborative effort featuring St. Peter's Anglican Cathedral Choir, Gervasia Arts Conservatory Orchestra, and the Florida A&M University Concert Choir under the direction of Dr. Mark Butler. I present to you, Lift Every Voice and Sing.
Thank you. Thompson, a senior at Cairo High School. The art department is exploring skills and talents with various media. From drawing to painting to decorative wood art, Mr. Scott Eastham has done a phenomenal job developing the students' unique abilities. In honor of Black History, we will showcase some original art pieces by our own CHS art students. Following the art display, we will have a presentation from the CHS Theater Club under the direction of Ms. Landry Bach. These students found time to prepare a piece in the midst of preparing for their spring production. I present to you from Cairo High School Fine Arts Academy, our art and theater presentations.
Patricia Arabath was an American ophthalmologist, inventor, and academic. She was an early pioneer of laser cataract surgery. Bath was the first African American to receive a patent for a medical purpose. In high school, she was inspired to pursue research. She also served as a professor at Howard University School of Medicine. In all, she lectured internationally and authored over 100 papers.
Muhammad Ali. He was raised in Louisville, Kentucky. Began training as an amateur boxer at age 12, and his former mentor was Malcolm X. Sarah Boone obtained United States patent number 473,563 for improvements to an ironing board. Boone was one of the four African-American women inventors of her time who developed new technology for the home.
Rosa Louie Parks was an American activist that was pivotal in the Montgomery boycott. On December 1, 1955, Rosa Parks rejected to leave a row of four seats for a white passenger on the colored section. She became an important symbol for the civil rights movement later in her life. She worked on an autobiography and always insisted that there was more work to be done in the way of justice.
Hello, I'm Kenna Anderson, a senior at Cairo High School, and I will be reading you a poem originally composed by myself entitled Happy Thoughts. Happy thoughts, brush it off. There's nothing you can do. They don't know what it's like to be you. You can't make them understand, so you let it come out through your hands onto paper. I get no waivers. This is me. Black is what I bleed. You know it when you see it. They keep spreading it out and now the streets leak it. All the pain and sorrow, the joys and hopes for tomorrow, all of that is in me. This brown skin and black pride will never leave me. You'll never understand and that's okay. Just don't come and lie to my face, shouting out about how you think you can relate. When you see through these eyes, that's a different experience. When you live this life, that'll make the difference. Then you'll understand. You'll know where we stand. Happy thoughts, brush it off. There's nothing you can do. They'll never fully understand what it's like to be you. But fight on, because that's what we do.
I am Kristen Robinson, a junior at Cairo High School. Our mission this year was to create great celebration of Black history and its impacts on the world we live in. The Cairo High School Sage Club, along with a group of faculty advisors, has selected a theme, More Than Meets the Eye. The goal was to provide an alternative perspective to help us focus on the bigger picture of Black history. This annual celebration highlights the contributions that Black Americans have made to U.S. history. The month-long observance grew out of an idea for Negro History Week, which was proposed by Carter G. Woodson. The collective vision for our Black History celebration was to emphasize that Black History Month should be regarded as a celebration that cannot be confined to a program, a week, or a month. We set out to create an atmosphere school-wide that enhances and embraces the Black American culture. We have so many talented students at our school. Some of their gifts and goals you may know, and some you may not. You never know what your fellow cert makers can do. Some of them might surprise you. We are more than meets the eye.
Prosperity. I'm walking in prosperity. Never in the way it's meant to. I'm Ricky Walker, a senior at Cairo High School. American Sign Language, or ASL, is a complete natural language that has the same linguistic properties as spoken languages. However, it has a grammar that differs from any English. ASL is expressed by movements of the hands and facial expressions. It is a primary language of many North Americans who are deaf and hard of hearing, and is used by many hearing people as well. At Cairo High School, the students may take ASL classes under the instruction of Mr. Nick Gijos. Today, our ASL students will be signing quotes from famous figures in Black history. I present to you members of our ASL club.
The battles that count aren't the ones for gold medals. The struggles within yourself, the invisible, inevitable battles inside all of us, that's where it's at. Jesse Owens.
Courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. Nelson Mandela.
You have to believe in yourself when no one else does. Serena Williams.
Success is loving life and daring to live it. Maya Angelou.
It is the mind that makes the body. Sojourner Truth.
Truth is proper and beautiful in all times and all places. Frederick Douglass.
Human progress towards the goal of justice requires sacrifice, suffering, and struggle. The tireless exertion and passion, concern of dedicated individuals. Martin Luther King, Jr.
I am Reverend Brown, a graduating senior. The genius of Ray Charles' 1959 Ray Charles album. Released in October by Lena Records, the seventh album since the debut Ray Charles in 1957. The album consists of swinging pop with big band arrangements. The album showcased Charles' breakout from rhythm and blues and into a broader musical stage. We have some talented geniuses of our own at Cairo High School that are making history each and every day. Next, we will have an opportunity to snap our fingers and tap our toes with the smooth sounds of Cairo High School Band. Let's welcome Cairo High School Symphony Band under the direction of Mr. John Scanlon.
Thank you. Hello, I am Crystal Mills, the Sage Club Vice President, and here to introduce our keynote speaker, Ms. Ann H. Flowers. She is a native of Cairo, Georgia. She was married to the late Reverend Henry Flowers Jr. for 50 years. She is the mother of 3 children and 3 granddaughters. Ms. Flowers was an educator in the Grady County school system over 30 years. During her tenure as an educator in Grady County, she held a number of positions. Most notably, Ms. Flowers was the first Black administrator in Grady County school system. After teaching at Washoe Consolidated High School, Shiver School, and Southside Elementary School, she was hired by the Board of Education to serve as the director of the Title V program. She went on to serve as assistant principal at Washington Middle School for 4 years. She served as an assistant principal at Cairo High School for 3 months before being named the principal at Washington Middle School from 1988 to 1996. She did such a phenomenal job that the superintendent asked her to return to serve as an intern principal at Washington Middle School from fall 1999 to spring 2000. The Sage Club would like to present to you a trailblazer in Grady County, Ms. Ann H. Flowers.
To Principal Loki, Ms. Armstrong, other staff and students of the Cairo High School, I want to express my sincere thanks to Ms. Armstrong for inviting me to come to speak on Black history. I like to think of it not just Black history, but also American history, because many Blacks have contributed to the making of these United States. Each year as we celebrate, there is a theme, and this year, 2021 theme, is Black Family, Representation, Identity, and Diversity. We ask ourselves how and why we celebrate Black history. There is so much to share, but due to the time, I'll try to condense and give you some important facts. The founder of Black history, Dr. Carter G. Woodson, and he's also known as the father of Black history. Black history is an annual celebration of achievements by African Americans and a time for recognizing their role in U.S. history. February is known as African American History Month. Years ago, American historian Dr. Carter G. Woodson established Negro History Week, and that was done nearly a century ago. It was first celebrated during the second week of February in 1926. It was called Negro History Week. But as time moved on, it began to be African Americans Week, African American Month. But at the beginning, it was called Negro History Week. The second week of February continued to be set aside for this event up until 1976, when the nation celebrated bicentennial. It was at that time that it expanded to be a months-long celebration. Since 1976, U.S. presidents have proclaimed the entire month of National African American History Month. It should last longer than 28 days, that's in February, or 29 days on a leap year. I think it should last year round. The event inspired schools, colleges, universities, communities nationwide to have some type of celebration for Black History Month. I would like to commend the Cairo High School for pausing to take the time to celebrate African American History Month. President Gerald Ford officially recognized Black History Month in 1976. He called upon the entire public to take the opportunity to honor the often neglected accomplishments that Black Americans in every area throughout our history have contributed to the American history. Many years ago, When I was in school, there weren't any written things in the textbooks about the contributions of Black history, of famous Blacks. Nothing highlighted the accomplishments of African Americans. We have African Americans who have excelled, been first in many areas such as sports, politics, education, music, theater, inventors, authors, and more. It would take too much time to highlight all of the accomplishments in each category, but let me pause just for a little while to highlight some of the famous people. I have to start with Jackie Robinson because we claim him. Jackie Robinson was born in Cairo, Georgia on January 19, 1919. He broke the color barrier in Major League Baseball. He was a trailblazer for other African Americans in sports. He is one African American that is celebrated all over the United States with many accolades, numerous celebrations, foundation, museums, and so forth. In 2009, Cairo Grady County established the Jackie Robinson Boys and Girls Club here. Also, a highway is named for Jackie Robinson, and it is called the Jackie Robinson Memorial Highway, 93 South, and it runs right here in front of Cairo High School. There is a monument at his birthplace south of Cairo, and it will be worth your time to take a drive down to look at that monument. Cairo High School named its baseball field the Jackie Robinson Field. We cannot celebrate Black history without mentioning Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Dr. King was a civil rights leader who practiced nonviolence. In his protests, he encouraged his followers, don't fight back. But you know, I think about if he could come back now, what would he think of all the violence going on in our state and in our nation? He would be surprised. Dr. King was arrested and jailed several times, but he did not let that stop him. He did not fight back. He delivered the famous I Have a Dream speech during the March on Washington, where over 200,000 people participated and there was no violence reported. There is a national holiday to honor Dr. King, where many events are held to celebrate. Parades, banquets, speeches. He was important enough to receive this recognition, and we all look forward to that day. Recently, we're sort of coming locally now. Recently, Mr. Lloyd Austin, a Thomasville native, was selected to be the Secretary of Defense. And we're so glad that we are right next to Thomasville, so we can sort of claim him too. Kamala Harris, first African American to become Vice President and the first woman to become Vice President. I have to mention Barack Obama, the first African American President of these United States, and he was elected for 2 terms. What history. Allow me to highlight a few more history makers and a few more inventors. You know anything about Harriet Tubman, who led hundreds of people through the Underground Railroad to freedom? Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on the bus to a white man, and that led to the Civil Rights Movement. Barbara Jordan, first congresswoman Black woman from the South. Charles Drew, African American who invented the blood bank. Booker T. Washington was founder of Tuskegee Institute, now Tuskegee University. George Washington Carver, a scientist, who developed 100 uses of the peanut. Thurgood Marshall was the first black Supreme Court judge. Colin Powell, the first black Secretary of State under President Bush. Did you know that the clothes dryer was invented by a black person, George Sampson? Did you know that the fire extinguisher was invented by Thomas Marshall? The traffic light to tell you when to go and when to stop and when to slow down, that was invented by Garrett Morgan. The elevator was invented by Alexander Miles. The air conditioning unit that we enjoy so much during the summertime was invented by a black man, Frederick Jones. The guitar that you like to play sometime, think about Robert Fleming. He invented that. And there's so many more. But let me come locally now, closer to home. Mrs. O.R. Williford was the first black to serve on the Grady County Board of Education. Mr. Sylvester Williams, Reverend Sylvester Williams, was the first black to serve on the Grady County Commissioners. Now these are local people. Mr. Ernest Cloud Jr. was the first black city councilman in the city of Cairo. Ms. Faye Copeland is the first woman to serve on the Grady County Commissioners. Teresa Edwards was a star basketball player here at Cairo High School. She went on and played at the University of Georgia, and she went on to win 3 gold medals in the Olympics, and we are proud of her. Yours truly has the honor of being the first black principal in Grady County since integration. As I close, let us remember that this month is a time to celebrate, to reflect, and to be inspired. There are many others who came before us to make our nation a better place to live, and they are continuing to make a name for themselves and make history. As I said, time will not allow me to highlight more of our famous African Americans, but I encourage you to visit your school library, visit your public library, and get on the computer and Google anything about black history so that you would know. Hopefully, there are many books and articles in our library. For 95 years, we have celebrated black history, and we want to keep on for many years to come. Again, thanks for having me. Happy Black History Month.
I am Nakai Brown, an 11th grader, and on behalf of Sage Club and Carroll High School, we would like to extend a special thank you to Ms. Ann H. Flowers for the inspiring message of hope. She truly shed light on how such a rich past allows us to look forward to an even greater future. It is both an honor and a privilege to have an opportunity to gain wisdom from such a poised member of our local black history. As the first black American to be appointed as principal in Grady County, our speaker has certainly made her mark on our community. Thank you, Ms. Flowers, for reminding the students, not only at Carroll High School, but throughout Grady County, that you believe in us, and anything is possible. With such an amazing resume, Mrs. Flowers has served in many capacities at both the county and state level. She has worked with and been a part of several organizations and affiliations. Hopefully, we can all go out and reach our potential and give back to the city of Cairo and Grady County like Mrs. Flowers has done for so many years.
Hello, I am Aaron Mora, a senior at Cairo High School. I Know I've Been Changed is a spiritual hymn that has transcended generations, from church services to grandmother singing it in the kitchen. This selection speaks on overcoming adversity, gaining a new outlook on life, and having hope for new things to come. The Cairo High School Chorus, under direction of Ms. Erica Edwards, will present Damon Dandridge's arrangement of this classical spiritual. I present to you the Cairo High School Chorus.
Thank you.
my day. You gotta do it now. My time, you can check your iPhone. Better say it's our time. I don't even need a watch, I don't even see a clock. Soon as I walk in, it feel like me a clock. Yeah, me a clock. Every time my checks don't measure up and try to blame the Pyrex. I'ma do it bigger than a 5X. Can't ride with an L, so I don't drive Lex.
Gangs.
Hello and welcome from Cairo High School. My name is Chris Loki. I'm principal here at Cairo High School. And as our celebration comes to an end, we truly hope that you have learned something you didn't know about Black history. Perhaps you found out something about another student that you may not ever have known, or heard an interesting fact, or heard a touching song. Whatever the case, we are glad that our Sage Club was able to put together an outstanding program despite the effects of the pandemic. We are extremely proud to be able to share our celebrations with each and every one of you virtually. Thank you for watching and thank you for supporting Cairo High School. For our grand finale, we will have a performance by the Cairo High School R&B dance team under the direction of Miss Hannah Russell.
One day, when the glory comes,
It will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure.
To the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory,
glory, glory.
Oh,
glory, glory.
Now the war is not over, victory isn't won, but we'll fight on to the finish, and then when it's all done, we'll cry glory, oh glory, oh glory. When the war is won, when it's all said and done, we'll cry.
Hello everyone, I am Erica Edwards and I am the co-chair of this year's Black History Celebration. The Sage Club has presented several activities to celebrate Black history and the African American heritage. The title of Heritage King and Queen is awarded to the male and female student who has demonstrated commitment to our celebration. Door decorations, virtual Black history, museum exhibits, Heritage Colors Day, and HBCU Day are among the many ways students could have participated in our celebration. I have the distinguished pleasure of presenting our Heritage King, Mr. Bryce Perry, and our Heritage Queen, Ms. Kenna Anderson. Congratulations, King Bryce and Queen Kenna.
Eu choro, Nagia, eu choro, Uyabale, o Satané.
Não, Cuiabale, Cuiabale, Cuiabale,
Nagia,
Cuiabaleca,
eu choro,
Cuiabaleca,
Nagia,
Satané,
eu choro,
Uyabale,
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 Uyabale. Satan,
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 Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan, Satan,
This year, we decided to do things a little differently to change the atmosphere across campus. Our goal was to get everyone in the spirit of celebrating Black history. When we initially launched the idea, we had about 12 to 15 prospective participants. After some expressions of competitive rivalry across campus and even across social media, things became a little bit more intense. But by the time the judges reviewed the entries, there were over 30 doors decorated. In order to ensure that the judges were unbiased, I solicited help from friends in Albany, Georgia, Atlanta, Georgia, Jacksonville, Florida, Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Cleveland, Ohio, and Harlem, New York. Before I announce the winner, I would like to recognize our judges. Each of our judges has at least one degree from my HBCU, the unsinkable Albany State University. Thank you to all of those Golden Rams for supporting the Cairo High School Sage Club. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. The following class's doors received honorable mention in our competition. Mr. Nick Jajos, Ms. Candace Childs, Ms. Paige Banks, Ms. Ashley Knight, Ms. Lindley Barrett, Ms. Kim Meredith, Ms. Regina Mitchell, Ms. Vanessa Dawson, Mr. Greg Boyce, and Ms. Alexandria Tice. In third place, with 46 points, Mr. Bryce Perry, or the band room. In second place, with 62 points, Ms. Casey Asbill. And our first place winner with 64 points. Drum roll, please. Congratulations to Mrs. Austin Harrell. She was our winner for our door decoration contest.
SAGE stands for Students Advocates for Georgia Education. The mission and purpose of this student organization is to cultivate the students' understanding of the value of education. With this in mind, it is important to acknowledge Black history as an essential component of American history.
Well, this has been an exceptional celebration. We have had to work around various schedules and quarantines, masks and social distancing, and so much more. We would like to thank everyone who made contributions to our celebration this year.
To our SAGE advisors and members, Cairo High School administrators, faculty, staff, and students, we would like to thank you for your support of our efforts to change the way we celebrate Black history.
Now please remember, Black history is far more than just 28 days of recognition of achievement and invention. It's an opportunity to educate and celebrate where we have come from.
And where we are going.
Thank you.